right, it's time for the PFL 10 breakdown in the welterweight division. It all goes down on Saturday night in Washington, D.C., the nation's capital. And remember, you got to fight twice in one night if you're one of the ones that keeps progressing. 25 minutes total. The first fight will be 10 minutes. A lot of weight on that first round. If you win that one, that's your tiebreaker. And then, obviously, the semifinals later on. So let's break down these names that we got here. Ghost from MMA Junkie Radio is going to give his predictions. And then at the end, I'll kind of whisper mine. I'm not the best at picking, making these picks, but I have fun doing it. So Ghost, at the very top, number one versus number eight. It's a rematch of what we saw earlier this summer. Ray Cooper III versus Jake Shields. What do you like here?
I feel like Jake Shields has a lot of room for improvement in this showing here against Ray Cooper. Ray Cooper, though, the way he speaks, the way he dismantled Jake in that first fight, and he's even looking to improve upon that in the second one. He wants to get rid of him in the first round. I think he's probably going to do it. It just comes down to that young lion. I got Ray Cooper advancing here.
All right. How about Rick Story versus Henderson Fajeya? That's a 4 versus a 5.
This is the nightmare matchup for me. I honestly want to say Rick Story, and I believe that there's ways that he can do this, but I'm actually going to go Henderson. I think the pressure that he brings in this fight, I really think he's going to give Rick some problems. I'm going to have him winning that fight, but I think it will go the distance.
That's a tough bracket.
Very tough. This is bad over here, too.
Now that I look at it, yeah, that's a pretty tough bracket. All right. Let's go to the lower bracket. Magomed Karamov. He doesn't make it easy for me. Versus Pavlo Kush. That's a 3 versus a 6. Who do you like here?
In this bracket, it can get pretty fuzzy because a lot of these guys have faced each other. And really, I would say, don't look at this. Just look at the performances that they've had. I'm going to go Magomed in this fight. I honestly think this will be the most competitive here, this side of the bracket. I think this will be a very competitive fight, but I think Magomed will win it. I think it'll go the distance, though.
Do you think it'd be okay if we called him Mago squared?
Yeah, why not?
Or Mago two times or something like that?
Yeah, if Ray Cooper's going to be the third, why not?
Yeah, I like it. All right. Abubakar. That's right. Abubakar Nurmagomedov. I really, really rehearsed that one. He'll be facing Bojan Velikovic. Who do you like in this one, Goz? That's a 2 versus a 7.
Another tough fight, and I really think they're going to let their hands go a little bit more in this fight than you expect. But I do have Abubakar winning this fight and advancing to the next one.
Nailed
round.
It. Abubakar. We really did rehearse that one. Yeah. All right. So let's do the next bracket because they fight twice in one night.
Yeah,
we're not letting you off the hook. So you went with Abubakar Nurmagomedov here versus Mago squared. Who do you like here? Oh, no, Mago two times. I like that one better.
Two times better? Yeah. Okay, yeah. Well, I like two times in this fight. Even though he is technically the third seed, Abubakar is the number two seed, I feel like he's going to have less of a challenge in this fight than Abubakar is going to have in this one. And I think that's going to play a role into the next round. So give me Magomed advancing here.
All right. How about up here? You went with Henderson Fajeya, which, by the way, you're sending Rick Story to retirement because he told us on today's MMA Junkie Radio show this might be the last time. I hope it isn't because I had fun watching Rick Story, but it may be his last time. But you did pick it.
I did.
Straight like you're supposed to. Fajeya here.
Now I feel like a jinx.
Advancing versus Ray Cooper. Who do you like in this one?
For as much good things as I said about Ray Cooper and the streak that he's on and just how well he's fighting, I honestly think Henderson is a handful here, and I think he's going to take it to Ray. I think it's the pressure. I think he's going to have him backpedaling a lot in this fight. So I'm actually going to go with Henderson.
All right. So Mago two times versus Henderson Ferreira. Make it to the finals in New York City on December 31st. All right. I'm going Cooper, Story, Mago two times, and Nurmi. Nurmi Light, we'll call him. That's Habib Nurmagomedov's cousin. And then from there, I'm going to go with Nurmi advancing here to the finals in New York City. And then coming out of this bracket, man, I think it's Cooper's time. I love the confidence he had. He was on today's show as well, and he just seems so focused. It's all in the family. That everybody trains together, works together. He addressed the loss that our co-host Dan Tom had asked him about, and doesn't seem flustered at all. He just feels like it's his time. So Cooper comes out of there for me versus Nurmi Light December 31st in New York City. They'll be fighting for $1 million if we're in any way correct. But hey, keep it locked on MMA Junkie throughout the weekend as we will be covering PFL 10. And also, don't forget to tune in to NBC Sports on Saturday, 9 p.m. Eastern start time for these welterweights quarterfinals and semifinals. Lastly, facebook.com/live on the day of the event. PFL is very prominent there. Tune into that because a lot of the prelims are played out on Facebook. And then they have some good pre- and post-fight analysis. So check it out. There you have it. The MMA Junkie Radio team breaking down the welterweight brackets at PFL 10.